Recently, Nintendo launched the OLED version of Switch. Lots of people will sell the old one, including charger within the box. That charger will be $30 when sold separately. So why will it be so expensive? And how can we pick up third-party charger when it was lost? Let's take a look. Open the packaging and there is only one charger inside. The overall appearance is just like a cube with a USB-C charging cable. AC output is 2 pins. Take a look at the charger specification. Model is HAC-002. Support valve voltage input of 100 volts to 240 volts and output of 5 volts 1.5 amp or 15 volts 2.6 amp. Manufacturer is Delta Electronics. The length of this cable is about 1.5 meter, which is pretty long, because typical length is about 1 meter. This cable comes from LineTag, which is also the charging cable supplier of Dell, Samsung, HP, and other brands. The size of this charger is between Apple's 30 watts and 61 watts. Let's use the tool to test its size and weight. Firstly, the size will be 65mm, 50mm, and 33mm, and the weight is 169 grams. Medium size. The ChargerLED Power Z shows it only supports PD 2.0 and DCB, and it also supports two fixed PDOs, 5V 105 amp and 15V 2.6 amp. We must need to know, the third-party charger needs to support 15 volts and the highest current is greater than or equal to 2.6 amp under 15 volts mode. Only this way can this charger support the TV mode. After removing the charger, let's start it to tear it down. The shell is very tough and is a little bit hard to open, because normally it will be open at this time. But this one, Okay, finally open it. But a small chip was accidentally full of. We will analyze it later on. The left side of the PCB is the primary circuit and the right is the secondary circuit. As for the components on the other side, the primary switch moist tube and the secondary synchronous rectifier moist tube have corresponding metal heat sinks. There are lots of silicon adhesives between the components to fix it and enhance the heat dissipation performance. The overall layout isn't very compact. There are a lot of gaps between the components. Maybe Nintendo has considered the heat dissipation performance after a long time running under TV mode and do it deliberately. Next, let's take a look at what's on PCB. There is an input rectifier bridge from Light On TT4M and a PWM controller ICs marked with DAP0500 and customized by Delta. An optocoupler comes from Everlight EL1013 and is placed between primary and secondary circuits for voltage feedback. The full-off one is the V-bus squeeze tube of output. Model is APEC-AP6679GM. With standard voltage is 30 volts. This is a USB PD portal chip marked with DAS012. An input delay fuse is in here. The specification is 2 amp 250 volts. The common mode choke adopts green magnetic core and is wrapped by copper tape. Here is the primary switching moist tube from Toshiba, model is TK10860DR. The two pins are covered with magnetic rings to reduce interference. The little thing next to it is a temperature protection component, which is connected in series with the power tube. Its limit temperature is 115 Celsius degrees. It'll disconnect the circuit when the temperature reaches 115 Celsius degrees to ensure safety. The blue one is the Y capacitor, which is used for output anti-interference. Here is a safety X2 capacitor. Capacity is 0.33 microfarad. The power supply capacitor of PWM chip is next to it, which comes from Rubicon, and the specification is 100 volts, 8.2 microfarad. There is some information on the top of transformer and output by multi-strained core. The electrolytic capacitors of input filter comes from Nippon Chemicon KHE series. Specification is 400 volts, 68 microfarad. The output filter capacitor is also from Rubicon. Specification is 25 volts, 820 microfarad. The secondary rectifier tube is next to it. Here is the secondary rectifier of Light On G40E100CTW. And the two pins are covered with magnetic rings. Okay, that will be all for today's teardown of Nintendo Switch 39W AC adapter, which is manufactured by Delta. The PWM controller and particle chip come from Delta. The capacitors are all Japanese. The overall quality belongs to the level of a first-class manufacturer. If you like this charger or need to buy one, you can go to Best Buy to take a look. If this video helps you, please drop a like and leave any comments. If you want to see more content like this, please subscribe to us and visit our website at chargerlab.com. See you next time!